Welcome to Dentsply Sirona Implants. My name is Chad Hébert. I'm an operations manager here. We're in Waltham, Massachusetts, just west of Boston, and today you're going to get a special look deep inside of our processes and meet some of the critical staff along the way. Come on, let's go for a ride. All right, here we are in receiving an order verification. And what happens here is, 20% of our cases that come in, we receive physically. The other 80% are digital. But we got to do a check to make sure that the product is correct. Jason, tell me what goes on in this area.
So in this area, this is basically where the physical order will first come in. The case pans will come in. We have a case pan person who opens up the boxes. They take that material out of that box, put all that material for that customer in a case pan, and they pass it on to the receiver. And the receiving personnel will then go ahead and scan in what we call a ship ticket. That ship ticket will give it a unique number, and that number will go off into the order verification area with the product. And our order verification technician is responsible for basically checking that order, verifying that everything that we request has been done. If it's straightforward, that case will then be sent off into our scanning department. It will be scanned, and that is how the actual model becomes digitized.
That would line up the process with the other 80% that we do.
Exactly.
All right, so now that we have everything digitized, we're gonna head on over to do some digital manufacturing using our custom VAD software in the design department. Hey, Bettina.
Hey, Chad, what's up?
So tell me about the superstructure product that you're working on right now.
So superstructures are multiple implant-supported restorations for the full edentulous or partially edentulous arches that we are fabricating in two ways, additive manufacturing and milling. And we are offering several products from removable to fixed, everything that is for the restorative need of the dentist.
So this is a one-off.
This is a custom-designed structure just for one patient and one patient only, yes.
And we do these all day long digitally.
All day long digitally.
Thanks for a lot of information, Bettina. I'm gonna go check out abutment design now.
See you later.
Thanks. Hey, Victoria.
Hey, Chad.
Looks like you got some fancy software here on the screen. What's so special about it?
I do. Actually, this is VAD, okay. Our software, Virtual Abutment Design. And as you can see, I'm designing two abutments here. And what's so special about it is that if we violate a regulation, meaning that the abutments cannot be milled, it gives us a warning.
And sometimes you have to contact the customer too.
If the case for some reason has issues that we cannot resolve on our own, as ADCs, we do need to, that's our main job, is to contact the customer and resolve the issues.
Now that we've seen how we do our digital manufacturing, we're gonna move into some physical manufacturing. We're gonna visit titanium machining first. Come on, let's go. Hey Dave, there's a lot going on here. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Sure. Here in Waltham, we produce the Atlantis custom abutment for the entire North American market. We also have a facility in Sweden where we produce our product for the European market, and a facility in Tokyo where we support Japan.
Wow, that must take a lot of automation.
It sure does. We've developed automation for all of our equipment to enable these machines to run 24/7, whether there's somebody in the building or not.
Oh, so how do we ensure the quality?
Well, we have a final inspection procedure that we perform over in our metrology department.
Well, can we go check that out?
Sure, let's go.
All right. In particular, the CMM machine is interesting. Can you tell us about it?
Sure. The CMM is a coordinate measuring machine. What this does is this allows us to fully inspect and measure all the critical dimensions of every abutment interface.
And why is that so important?
Well, for one thing, it's an FDA requirement for us to maintain this quality data. But the other thing is, really, these things are going into a person's mouth, and this is intended to be with them for the rest of their life.
That's awesome, Dave. Now we're off to zirconia operations. Peter, how are you doing today?
Great, Chad, and you?
I'm great. Tell me about this area. What's going on in here?
Oh, we do a lot over here. We make zirconia abutments here.
Yep.
We also make zirconia crowns.
And a little bit of the Azento product
there. Oh, definitely. That's a big product for this year.
I guess some piloting and R&D is also in this room.
Oh, that's huge for us. When you have a new product, a new idea, we work with them to develop the equipment, develop the process, industrialize the process to ship to customers.
So very integrated with development and also operations, right in the middle. Thanks so much, Peter.
You're welcome, Chad.
All right, next stop, we're off to the Advanced Manufacturing Center of Excellence. Let's go check it out. All right, and here we are. We're at the new Advanced Manufacturing Center of Excellence. We've got a ton of new manufacturing equipment here, 3D metal printing, different types of resin printing. We've got a whole bunch of new manufacturing processes that are being introduced into this area. It's gonna be a whole new magical place for us to build product. Come on in. The really exciting thing we're doing here is we're doing 3D metal printing. So today we're gonna talk to Bryan Sullivan, one of our operations engineers, to get into the details of it.
Additive manufacturing is really an emerging and disruptive technology. One of the advantages of this process is that it isn't constrained by some of the design requirements of other manufacturing processes. So that really enables you to make geometry that you can't really make with other processes. The way the geometry is formed in this process is really kind of, it's digitized. So you're breaking things down into slices, and then you're kind of conforming the way it's put together. So it's like automating the geometry generation.
What does it mean for the customer?
Really, it enables you to get cost-efficient and timely production of patient-specific geometries.
All right, so like I mentioned before, we also have resin printing. This here is where we do our Simplant guides for our new Azento product. Bryan's gonna tell us a little bit more about the difference between resin printing versus metal printing. Bryan?
Sure, so basically they're both laser-based processes. The resin-based printing is it's a photopolymer. So basically the UV laser is polymerizing the resin into a solid, where the metal can be thought of as more of like a micro welding process.
Okay.
So basically you have powdered metal and the laser is actually melting all the particles together.
Thanks, Bryan. All right, so now that you've seen the Center of Excellence, we're gonna see how all the products come together and go into our quality control department. Out the door to you. So now we're coming into our quality control and shipping department. This is where all of our products get married together, doing an inspection before we ship it out the door. This place looks like it's pretty automated. Can you tell us a little bit about that, Jason?
Sure, so yeah, we do have a couple of integrated systems here, you know, and it's very self-explanatory, and it just helps the operator, you know, in order to get the job done without any problems or any errors.
Awesome, that must totally help us out with our FDA regulations that we have to do.
Oh, definitely. I mean, especially when you have a medical device that is going into a patient's mouth, we have to make sure we have that clearance.
From digital manufacturing to physical manufacturing, you guys have seen it all. So I just want to thank you for coming and visiting Dentsply Sirona Implants. Until next time, I got work to do. See you later.